We have this silent crisis in the Mano River sub-region. More people died of Ebola than survived Ebola. And those who died, they left their children behind. We have tens of thousands of orphans and children who have lost their primary caregiver to Ebola. And then the health aspect. There was lack of healthcare in the remote forest regions of eastern Sierra Leone, where the three countries meet, Liberia, Sierra Leone, Guinea. And that's where Ebola erupted. And because there was not enough healthcare, there wasn't enough social welfare services there. The social worker, that's the gossiper, the one that goes into the community, picks up gossip and brings it out to tell the government. And if we had an effective social workforce in place, when Ebola struck, he would have realized that 25 people died in Pondo village of some strange diarrhea vomiting. And he would have gossiped upwards to the district level, who would have gossiped upward to the regional level, and gossiped upward right to the minister's desk. So we have to get the focus of government into the aspect of strengthening the social workforce, the community worker who goes into the communities. And one of the first things I did on taking up office was to set up an Ebola unit, Ebola survivors unit in the ministry, which is like a desk, which is manned by an Ebola survivor herself. Because I envisage a long-term relationship with Ebola survivors. I'm fully aware that they're not just going to disappear into thin air, because there are some people who think that the Ebola survivors, Ebola is gone, we're finished with Ebola, let's forget about survivors, let's pretend they don't exist. There are some people who hold that view. I hold the totally contrary view, which is the view shared by my boss, His Excellency the President, which is that we have to keep engaged with the survivors. And they also become ambassadors for lessons learned in infection and prevention controls. So I'm seeing a bright future for them. I want them to be our partners on an equal level, so they can be empowered to be a formidable force that can be a force for good.